Hello friends, I am Milka Jagale, working as assistant professor in Department of Mechanical Engineering, Walchand Institute of Technology, Solapur. Today we are going to study of automatic control systems. What are automatic control systems and a classification regarding that? So let's start. At the end of the session, students will be acquainted with basics of control system and identify different control systems. What is automatic control engineering? Automatic control engineering has played an important role in advancement and improvement of engineering skills. Control systems are integral part of the modern industrialization, industrial process, and home appliances. Every activity in our day-to-day life is influenced by some sort of control system. This presentation includes concept of system and control systems. What is system? System is a combination or arrangement of different physical components which act together as an entire unit to achieve certain objective. Let's take an example of classroom. A classroom is a good example of physical system. A room, along with the combination of benches, blackboard, fans, lighting arrangement, can be called a control classroom, which acts as an elementary system. A lamp made up of glass filament is a physical system. A kite made up of paper and sticks is an example of physical system. What is control system? To control means to regulate, to direct, or to command. Hence, a control system is an arrangement of different physical elements connected in such a manner so as to regulate, direct, or command itself or the other system. If in a classroom, professor is delivering his lecture, the combination becomes a control system as he tries to regulate, direct, or command the students in order to achieve the objective, which is to impart good knowledge to the students. If a lamp is switched on or off using a switch, the entire system can be called a control system. I just want to pause the video for a few seconds and think about different control systems that you come across in your day-to-day life. So this is a classification of control system. Control systems are broadly classified as follows: natural control system, man-made control system, combinational control system, time variant and time invariant control system, linear and non-linear control system, continuous time and discrete time control system, deterministic and stochastic control system, lumped parameter and distributed parameter control system, CISO, single input, single output, and MIMO, multiple input, multiple output. And the last, open loop and closed loop control system. Let's see each control system in detail. First one, natural control system. The biological systems inside human being are of natural type. Human body is one of the good example of natural control system. Regulation of temperature of human body. Second, man-made control system. The various control systems we are using in our day-to-day life, which are designed and manufactured by human beings, such as accelerator and braking system. And here comes the next, combinational control system. As the name indicates, combinational control system is a combination of natural and man-made together. Example we'll take here, driver driving the vehicle. For successful operation of the system, it is necessary that natural control system of driver along with the system in the vehicle must be active. Time variant control system. In this, all the parameters vary with respect to time. Example we'll take here of space vehicle. As the space vehicle leaves the earth surface, the mass of that goes on decreasing, and here mass is the parameter. The next come time invariant control system. All the parameters in the system, if they does not vary with respect to time, the system is known to be time invariant control system. In case of rocket, aerodynamic damping, it goes on changing as the air density goes on changing. Here the next come linear system. A system is called to be linear system if the principle of superposition is valid. That is, it has to follow the two rules. First, additive property. Second, homogeneity. If the system does not follow the principle of superposition, then the system is said to be non-linear system. Here, the output is directly proportional to the input in linear, and in non-linear, the output is not proportional to the input. Here, a continuous time control system. All the system variables are function of a continuous time variable T. Example, analog system, speed control of DC motor using TACO generator feedback. Next, discrete time control system. In this, one or more system variables are known at discrete time interval. Example, digital system, microprocessors, or computer-based systems. Next, deterministic control system. The system in which output can be predicted due to changes in the input entering into the system. Stochastic control system. System in which output cannot be predicted due to changes in the input entering into the system or external disturbances. Lumped parameter control system. In this, it is a system in which whose equation of operation is ordinary differential equation. Example, electrical networks with different parameters like resistance and inductance. Distributed parameter control system. These are the systems in which equation of operation is partial differential equation. Example, transmission line having its parameters, resistance and inductance totally distributed along it. Here comes the CISO, that is, name itself indicates, a system having only single input and single output is called as CISO control system. Multiple input and multiple output are nothing but a system having multiple input and multiple outputs is called as MIMO. Here comes open loop control and closed loop control system. Open loop control system, a system in which input signal is independent on output signal. Here the input is given to the process and we get the output. The next come closed loop feedback system. Here a system in which input signal is dependent on the output signal. Here the output is given back to the input so that the output is controlled by the input. Here a feedback element is introduced. So let's see what is feedback. Feedback is a key tool that can be used to modify the behavior of a system. Feedback compares output signal with input signal in order to generate error signal to achieve or generate desired output. Feedback is present in closed loop control system. So these are the references, a book by U.A. Bakshi and the other book, Automatic Control Engineering by Francis Raven. Thank you.